Hi folks, my name is Luis Ibarrocal. On this episode, we're going to be working on how to use selections and buffers in ArcGIS 10.6 to do a simple analysis. If you want to follow the tutorial along, you can find the data at bit.ly/LuisIbarrocal_selection. Now what's our challenge? We want to raise money to build a free meal center for people of low income. The idea is to help as many communities as possible that are as close as possible. We have determined that the radius between communities will be 2.5 kilometers. And we want to help communities with more than 250 people where the average income is less than $150 a month. Here we have our towns, our streets, Cocle, which is a province in Panama, and we have in the background the whole country of Panama. Now, first thing we're going to do is we're going to click here and we're going to do selection, select by attribute. Move this a little bit here. We're going to make sure we have on layer Cocle, and we're going to find ing_PRM, which is okay. And we double click on ing_PRM, which is ingreso promedio in English, that would be average income. We want an average income which is less than 150, and we want the towns to have more than 250 people. So we select and, we double click on personas, which is Spanish for people, and we do a greater than 250. So now we're going to select communities or towns in Cocle which have earnings below 150 and have more than 250 people. I'm going to do apply. Okay, now you can see all these have been selected. These are the towns we want to work with. We could do the whole analysis just with the selection, but I want to show you how to create another feature class based on this selection. So I'm going to right click on Cocle Town. I'm going to go to data. I'm going to say export data. And I'm going to save them inside my Cocle_nat27. And I'm going to export them as towns in need. Click save. And click OK, and I'm going to add it to the current map. Yes, and if I turn off Cocle Towns, you can see that now I only have the towns that I selected in another feature class. Now what we're going to do is we're going to do a buffer of 2.5 kilometers to know how well the data is clustered. So we're going to use as input feature, towns in need. We're going to select, we're going to name our towns in need, buffer. We're going to save it. We're going to type here 2,500 meters, which is kilometers. And we're going to keep the method as planar. We could use a geodesic, but we're going to keep it planar. Now we're going to use dissolve all, because I want all my polygons to be dissolved into just the polygons that are clustered together. So I'm going to click on OK. Now you can see it has added here my towns in need buffer. You can see the circles and now they're clustered together. If you take a look at our buffers, you would figure that our attribute table would have at least, I don't know, 20, maybe 25 records. But when we open it, we right click here, we do open attribute table. We find that it has only 3 records. For some reason, it created a multipart feature. I don't understand the criteria it uses to group them together, but this will not work. What we need to do it is change it from a multi-part feature to a single part. So we're going to deselect here, close the attribute table, and we're going to click here in search. And here we have to use multi-part, single part. Click here, select our buffer, and we're going to call it Tanzanit buffer single. And to save, click OK. And now we have our new Tanzanit buffer. We're going to right click on our attributes, open attribute table. And now you can see we have 24 features. Now if we select, you can see they're all, you can see here, you're selecting them. So it did what we expected. So we have our attribute table, deselect here. As you can see, we need to find a way to bring the data from Tanzanit into the polygons so I can do a summarize and do an analysis of which areas have more or less income and in order to calculate the earnings per capita. So what we're going to do is a spatial join. So we're gonna type here spatial join. Click for spatial join attribute. And we're going to choose as our target feature our Tanzanit buffer single, and our join will be our Tanzanit. Click here. We're going to name buffer single, and we're going to add the attributes. Attributed. So I know brings. We're going to do a one-to-many because I want all the towns that touch the polygon to be associated with the record. And I'm going to choose as a match option intersect, which means they need to intersect into each other. And I'm going to click OK. So you can see it has created for me and added into the table of content. Now let's right click and open attribute table, and you see now I have 62 records, and that is because now it is a multi-part, it has a relationship one to many. So let's select this and make it the only selectable layer. I'm gonna right click here, we will do selection, make this the only selectable layer. And I'm going to select this big polygon here, choosing the selection select feature. Click here. And I'm going to click here so I can only see this record. So you see, this polygon has 25 records associated with it. Now my next step is to find a way to summarize the data so it'll add up my income per cap, my monthly earnings, and my how many people are in each polygon. Now to do a summary, what we're going to do is run a dissolve. First thing we're going to do is we're going to clear selection and close the attribute table, and we're going to double click on dissolve. As input feature, we're going to use our Tanzanit buffer single attributed, and we're going to name this, we're going to append to it summary. So that'll be the summary. Next thing I'm going to do as a dissolve field, target FID. What this is going to do, it's going to join all the towns that are inside one polygon. Otherwise, it would just add all the fields together. So I'm going to choose here ING prom, which is average income. I'm going to select here to be a sum. Next, I'm going to choose personas, which is people. Sorry. I'm going to double click here. I'm going to choose zoom. And I'm going to choose account on código, which is code. here to find it. Double click here, and I'm going to choose a count. So when this will tell me how many towns are inside the polygon. We're going to click keep the create multipart feature on, and we're going to keep the unsplit line deselected. We're going to click OK. As you can see, it has added our summary. We're going to right click here to do open attribute table. And as you can see now, I have the summary fields. I have how much money per town there is, how many people in the polygon there are. I mean, this is not per town, this is per polygon. And we're going to do a little bit more with it in a bit. Now I'm going to add two columns to my summary feature class. For that, I'm going to click into our catalog. And I'm going to find my summary here. Right click on it, and I'm going to click on properties. And I'm going to find the fields tab, and I'm going to add here, click here, and I'm going to tap per capita income. It's going to be a double. And my index, which is the index I'm going to use to evaluate which polygon is more, which area is more suitable to give aid to. Click OK. As you can see here, it has already added both columns. So now I'm going to calculate my per capita income. So I'm going to click here on the per capita income. I'm going to use field calculator, and my formula is, delete this, is the sum of average incomes divided by the sum of people. Click OK. Now I'm going to calculate my index. My index is a way I decided I wanted to evaluate how many towns I was helping, so I'm going to multiply the per capita income by the count of code. So I'm going to right click here, I'm going to field calculator, I'm going to delete this, and I'm going to go with per capita income times count of code. Click here, and now I'm going to order this, so the ones with the highest, and I'm going to click on the highest with my index. And as you can see, this polygon here in this area. So I would recommend the people who are trying to place to places in this area, the free food place should be placed in this area. As usually, thank you so much for watching, and if you like the content, please consider subscribing to my channel. Thank you very much.